Hello there, lovely people. It's Alex from Nintendo Life here. Now, if you've been on the internet and you've been nosing around in various corners, you may well have seen these images appear. Look at them. If you haven't seen these before, or if you just have no idea what you're looking at for some reason, these are supposed leaked images of the N64 Mini, or Classic Edition, or whatever they like to call it, I never remember. At first glance, these things look the business. I mean, you know, it looks like an N64, shrunk down, and just, you know, with all the stupid stuff like the little flat bit that comes out of a SNES Mini. Even if you look at the underside, all the information is correct with a European version. A lot of people have said that, oh, well, it says Nintendo Japan, or it says Kyoto and stuff like that, and yet it says to go to support.nintendo.com. But that's what it looks like on the underside of the SNES Mini. I'll show you. Might be different in North America, I don't know, but the fact is that it's good. The detailing seems to be good, it genuinely looks the business. So, is it real? No, did you read the title? There are a couple of really glaring issues with this thing. I mean, you know, I'm not saying that it absolutely isn't real, because, you know, there are some things, you know, maybe it's like a pre-production thing, or a mock-up, or a proof of concept done by Nintendo, but, you know, there are some things that really throw it into question, like, a lot. Like, I would bet money that this isn't real. That's how confident I'm feeling. So what are these things, Alex? What makes you some sort of authority? Why are you a font of such knowledge? Are you just talking out of your ass? Well, I'll tell you how I know. I've got an N64. If you've got an N64 in your home, go and pick it up and, you know, sort of have a rummage around and see if you can see some of the issues that I'm talking about. Although I will also show you in the video. So if you don't have one, don't worry. Let me just remind myself of all the rubbish. Some of you who've been looking at your N64 may say, well, the underside looks totally different. I mean, under here, it's, you know, it's all these vents and stuff. And there's the external port that was never really used. I mean, there was the 64DD, but we all know how well that went down. And to be fair, you are right. It does look different underneath. Much smoother. No real sort of port or anything like that. Even a fake one, you know, which Nintendo like to do with their sort of things. But then all you need to do is look underneath your SNES, yellowed as it is. I've got my SNES here. Obviously, this is a European one, so it's the right one. And underneath, you can see here, there is an external port for the... Oh, blimey, should I even really be taking this out? Probably not. It's probably quite fragile. There's the external port under there for the, what was it? The Satellaview, wasn't it? That, again, we all know how well that went down. But then if you look at a SNES Mini, there's nothing like that underneath. It looks somewhat similar underneath, but really, it's just the bottom of a console. You don't see it. So I would say that that is not a mark against it. If anything, it probably strengthens it, the fact that it's slightly different. But there's plenty of other stuff that says otherwise. Oh yes, we're getting into typography. You can no doubt tell that the memory expansion slot on this mini version, this mocked up one, this image that we've got, is not actually a port, but is in fact just printed on, which is understandable, because why would you actually make it changeable and have a jumper pack in there, whatever the hell they called this thing? It just makes much more sense to print it on, or even just emboss it or something like that. So, you know, sort of just a graphic on there, it's not that ludicrous. So, you know, that part makes sense. However, if you look very closely at the text, you can see that not only do they not really match the original, but also that's some horrible, horrible kerning. For those that don't know, kerning is basically just the gaps between letters, and, you know, generally computers aren't brilliant at doing it, so you have to do it manually in order to make it look just right. But I mean, look at the gap between the R and the Y. It's horrible, and the P and the A, and even the A and the N to a degree, and the E and the X. Overall, just there are just these horrible big gaps, and you know for sure that Nintendo would not do that. Anything like that just wouldn't make it out of the factory, because they are sticklers for that kind of thing. And they managed to do it before, why couldn't they do it again? You know what they could even do? They could even use the same sodding font. If you look really closely, it's not even the same font. Like, not even slightly. I mean, okay, it is close, but it is definitely not the same font. For example, look at how the O looks, for example. The R is totally different as well. It's even more noticeable on the reset button. We get a decent look at the reset button in this picture, and now compare it to the actual factual real N64. The R especially is completely different. It's generally fairly straight, and in the original, it's curvy. look at the curves. Also, speaking of curves, if you look at the reset button in this mock-up, then you can see that it's a lot more bent than the actual real N64. A very minor detail and one that could actually be on the thing, but even so, it's worth pointing out, I think, because I want to. Another thing that's worth mentioning is, for some reason, we don't get a good look at the power switch, which just seems a bit odd to me, and you can't really see any real Nintendo logo like the Nintendo logo at the top here that says Nintendo. For some reason, we just don't see it, and that seems a little bit convenient to me because they would probably be quite hard to recreate. I mean, come on, they basically didn't manage to get the memory expansion thing to look right, so the power switch probably just couldn't do it, or just couldn't be bothered. You do see a tiny bit of the sort of like the grippy part, the ridge, in this photo, but overall, yeah, that's all we can see. And the final nail in the coffin, the crowning turd of the hamper, is the N64 logo itself. Now, the actual 3D N-type thing looks pretty good. Overall, it looks pretty much the same, except for it's not faded like mine. But the actual word Nintendo above it is far, far too bold. It is much thicker than you can see on the original. And again, Nintendo are massive sticklers for this kind of thing. Like, they just wouldn't let something like this go through. It would have to look exactly the same, and if anyone's going to have access to the original files, Nintendo's going to do it. Also, they could just recreate it if they needed to, and they wouldn't make it as bold. They'd make it exactly the same. Also, the 64 is really bold. Like, really, really, really bold. Also, Nintendo's in white when it should be in grey, so yeah. I have to give props for how they've made it, because the first time I saw it, I thought to myself, hey, yeah, I could see that being a real thing. But, you know, there are these little errors here and there, few little details that they just didn't pick up on, or maybe didn't even notice, and, you know, it just allows it, you know, they just slip through the net, and it just makes it all the more obvious that it's not a real. I mean, don't get me wrong, I do think that the N64 Mini will be a real thing in the future, I just think that we're not there yet, and this isn't it. Frankly, I think Nintendo would be mad not to release an N64 Mini, because the SNES Mini, the NES Mini, they've done so well, why wouldn't they continue doing it? And especially the N64 being the sort of the, almost the sort of the freshest retro system in terms of Nintendo's lineup. Of course, everyone will have their own line where it is. Some people may consider the Wii retro, but I don't. The N64 is retro, GameCube is borderline. And who doesn't want to be able to use the N64 controller again? I'm hoping we'll be able to use something else. I do love the N64 controller, but it is a bit bad, isn't it? It's a bit bad. But anyway, I think generally that's that put to bed. I'm no doubt not the first person to come up with these observations, because, you know, it's the internet, and this is three days old, but that was a Saturday, and I don't work Saturdays, and some people think that's a bad thing, but, you know, people on YouTube, we need our weekends as well. But if you do have any thoughts of your own about all this, or you just want to say something like first, then make sure you do so down there in the comments. Unless it's first. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then why don't you debunk that subscribe button based on the space between two different letters? And be sure to check out NintendoLife.com for all sorts of lovely Nintendo-related content. Thank you again for watching. Bye-bye. Oh.